In the world of modern software development, application programming interfaces, or also known as APIs, have emerged as the building blocks of connectivity, enabling various applications and services to communicate effectively. However, as the number of APIs within an ecosystem grows, so do the complexities of managing and securing them. This is where the API gateway steps in, as a crucial component of a well-structured software architecture. But hey, what is an API gateway? Well, at its core, an API gateway can be likened to the concierge at a grand hotel. Just as the concierge serves as a central point of contact for hotel guests, an API gateway acts as the central entry point for all the incoming and outgoing API traffic in a software system. In a sense, an API gateway serves several vital roles in the realm of APIs, starting with number one, routing traffic, wherein, similar to how the concierge directs guests to the appropriate destinations within the hotel, an API gateway routes incoming requests from clients such as application, devices, or users to the appropriate backend services or microservices. Next, simplifying complexity. It abstracts the complexity of a potentially intricate backend architecture, providing clients with a unified and standardized interface for interacting with various APIs. Next, enhancing security. Just as a concierge ensures the security of the hotel, an API gateway provides a robust security layer by handling authentication, authorization, and protecting against common web threats. And managing scalability. In the same way that a concierge manages guest traffic during peak hours, API gateway helps manage the scalability and performance of your APIs by load balancing requests and preventing overloading of the backend servers. Now that we have understood the basic concept of what is API gateway, let's dive deeper into why API gateways have become indispensable in today's software landscape, or to say the least, why do we need API gateways? Well, simply because of the following reasons. Number one, streamlining complex backend systems. Well, in modern applications, backend systems often consist of a multitude of microservices, each serving a specific purpose. Now, these microservices can be distributed across different servers or even cloud providers, and that's why, without an API gateway, clients would need to know the intricacies of each microservice's location and endpoint, making integration a nightmare. For example, imagine a retail application that needs to display product information, reviews, and pricing. Instead of making separate requests to different microservices for each piece of data, the application can make a single request to the API gateway, which then orchestrates the calls to the relevant microservices, thereby simplifying the client's experience. Next, number two, enhancing security. Now, security is paramount in today's digital landscape. We already know that API gateways act as a security guard for APIs, thereby ensuring that only authorized clients gain access to specific resources. Additionally, they also handle authentication and authorization, thereby adding an extra layer of protection against malicious actors. Next, managing traffic and performance. Now, as application grows in popularity, they may face the challenge of handling increased traffic. Here, API gateways help in managing this traffic by load balancing requests across multiple backend servers. And they also implement rate limiting and throttling to prevent abuse and ensure fair resource allocation. We'll learn more about this later in this video. But for the sake of an example, let's consider any popular e-commerce platform during a Black Friday sale. The API gateway distributes incoming requests evenly across multiple server instances, thereby preventing any single server from being overwhelmed and ensuring a smooth shopping experience for users. Cool, right? Next, let's discuss how API gateway works. Now that we understand the significance of API gateways, let's explore how they work in more detail. An API gateway performs several critical functions, including request routing and load balancing, authentication and authorization, and rate limiting and throttling. Let's understand each one of them one by one. First, request routing and load balancing, in which Request routing implies that API gateways are like traffic controllers for incoming requests. They examine each request destination and direct it to the appropriate backend service or microservice. This routing is often based on criteria such as requested resources path, HTTP method, be it get, post, put, or delete, or even custom headers. For example, in a cloud-based storage service, the API gateway routes requests for file uploads to one set of servers responsible for storage, while requests for file downloads are routed to another set of servers designed for retrieval. This ensures efficient resource allocation and optimal performance. Next is load balancing, which is a critical aspect for ensuring high availability and performance. Here, API gateways distribute incoming requests evenly across multiple backend servers. This prevents any single server from becoming a bottleneck and allows the system to scale horizontally as traffic increases. Second, authentication and authorization, in which authentication implies as the process of verifying the identity of a client or a user. API gateways handle authentication by validating the credentials provided by the client, which can include API keys, tokens, or other authentication mechanisms. For example, when you log into your email account, the API gateway verifies your username and password before granting access to your inbox. If the credentials are incorrect, the access is denied. Next is authorization, which determines what actions a client is allowed to perform once they have been authenticated in the system. So, here, API gateway enforces authorization rules to ensure that clients only access resources and perform actions that they are permitted to do. For example, in a content management system or CMS, the API gateway ensures that only administrators can create, edit, or delete content while regular users are limited to viewing and commenting. Third, rate limiting and throttling, in which rate limiting signifies as a strategy used to control the number of requests a client can make to an API within a specific time frame. API gateways enforce rate limits to prevent abuse, protect backend resources, and ensure fair usage. For example, a social media API may implement rate limiting to allow each user to make a maximum of 100 requests per hour to prevent automated bots from overwhelming the service. Next, throttling, which simply goes hand in hand with rate limiting. It involves slowing down or delaying requests that exceed the defined rate limits. Throttling ensures that even if a client exceeds their rate limit, they won't disrupt the overall system's performance. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.